Hi everyone, and welcome back to the channel. This is a problem sent in by a viewer. If you want to give this problem a go, pause the video now, and when you're ready, we'll go through the solution. We'll begin by converting each of our bases into base 10, so we can do that using the following formula, and we can write this as 2m plus 2m cubed. And so we're looking for the sum from 3 to n of 2m plus 2m cubed, which we can write as the sum of 2m plus the sum of 2m cubed. And factoring out the 2, we can write this as 2 lots of the sum of m plus 2 lots of the sum of m cubed. And summing m from 3 to n is the same as going from 1 to n, and then we'll just minus 1 minus 2. So we can write this as 2 lots of n times m plus 1 all over 2 minus 1 minus 2. And we can do the same thing with m cubed, so we can sum that from 1 to n, which is n squared n plus 1 squared all over 4, and then minus 1 cubed minus 2 cubed. And so simplifying this down, this becomes n plus 1 minus 6 plus n squared n plus 1 squared all over 2 minus 18. And then simplifying this once more, we have the following. Now we're looking to find when this expression is divisible by 2020, or in other words, when it's congruent to 0 mod 2020. And we can go ahead and times everything by 2 for the following. And we can try and factorize the first two terms. So we can write that as n plus 1 in one bracket and n plus 1 in the other. And then this would be plus 1 and plus 1. And then we need to minus the 1 and then bring back in the 48. And so we have that this is n squared plus n plus 1 squared minus 7 squared. Which means we can now factorize this as a difference of two squares. So this would be n squared plus n plus 8 times n squared plus n minus 6. And we can factorize again the second of these two quadratics as n plus 3 times n minus 2. Now, if we look at the prime factors of 2020, this is 2 squared times 5 times 101, which would mean that each of these expressions must be 0 mod one of these prime factors. And for all positive integers n minus 2 is less than n plus 3, which is less than n squared plus n plus 8. Which would mean that if one of these expressions were to be 0 mod 101, then it would follow that n must be at least 98. So if we are to find the smallest solution, then we better look when n squared plus n plus 8 is 0 mod 101. And then it would follow that the other two expressions would either be 0 mod 5 or 0 mod 2, so that we can write the following. And notice that when n plus 3 is 0 mod 5, this is saying n is congruent to minus 3, which is congruent to 2 mod 5. And likewise from this one, we also have that n is congruent to 2 mod 5. And thus we're saying that if this is true, then in either case, we end up with n being a multiple of 5 plus 2. And so if we substitute 5k plus 2 into our expression, we have the following. And expanding and simplifying, this becomes 25k squared plus 25k plus 14. And we can factorize the first two terms as 25k times k plus 1. And then this shows us that k times k plus 1 will always be an even, and 25 times an even will always end in a 0, meaning that when we add 14 again, we know that this entire expression must be 4 mod 10. So thus we're saying that if n squared plus n plus 8 is equal to 101 times m for some integer m, then it must be 4 mod 10. But that can only be true when the values of m are either 4, 14, 24, and so on. And so looking at our first case when m equals 4, we have n squared plus n is equal to 396, which would mean n times n plus 1 is 396, but this has no solutions. Our second case where m equals 14, we have that n plus 1 is 1406. And that can be written as 37 times 38, and thus we know that n is equal to 37. And since this is smaller than 98, we know that this must be our smallest solution.